Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Anaconda on a Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Anaconda, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar you need to just simply type Anaconda download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this www.anaconda.com is basically our first source result. So just simply click on this individual edition Anaconda and it will going to redirect you to this official site of Anaconda, and you can see we are currently in our Anaconda's official site. So here you can see that we have this download button for Windows, so it has rightly recognized that I am using a Windows operating system. So if you are using some other operating system like Linux or Mac, then also it's going to be recognized and it will going to show this download button for that respective operating system. So since I am using Windows, so it has rightly recognized as Windows. So just simply click on this download button to download our Anaconda and see it has rightly started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it, and if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can see Anaconda 3 2021.11 has rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it, and you can see that our Anaconda installation wizard has rightly opened over here. So let us just minimize our download directory, and here just simply click on next. And this is our license agreement, so just, you know, simply click on agree, and here it is asking whether you'd like to install it for just yourself or for all users. So you can install it for, you know, just for yourself, so which is also a recommended one. So just simply click on next, and this is going to be our installation destinations. So, you know, keep this as a default. You can see that about 3 GB of space it will require to install in our C drive. So that's a very important, guys. You need to have at least that much amount of space in your C drive. Do always check that, because this 3 GB is quite a significant number, right? So do check that, and then just simply click on next. And here it is asking whether you'd like to set Anaconda 3 to my path variable. So do also check that, and then just simply click on install. And what it will do is it will going to start installing our Anaconda. See, it has rightly started. So this installing Anaconda will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our Anaconda. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Anaconda had rightly installed. So just, you know, simply click on next, and here just, you know, simply click on next. So completing our Anaconda 3 setup installation. So just simply click on finish, and you'll be seeing that our browser had rightly opened with, you know, Anaconda nucleus. I'm going to switch to this Anaconda tab. We have these tutorials, then we also have this quick start guide. So I'm going to minimize it, and I'm going to launch our Anaconda. So for that, just simply click on search icon, and here just simply type Anaconda, and you'll be getting Anaconda Navigator in our search result. So you need to just simply click on our Anaconda Navigator, and what it will do is it will going to start launching our Anaconda Navigator. And as you can see, our Anaconda Navigator has rightly launched over here. So here you can see that we have so many products listed over here, right? So the most popular one is this Jupyter Notebook, right? And another popular one is this Spyder. So this Jupyter Notebook and Spyder both are used extensively for machine learning related projects. And we also have this PyCharm Professional, so you can directly install it by just, you know, simply proceed with this install button. And I'm going to also show you now how to use this Spyder and Notebook. So for that, stay tuned till the end of the video. So first I am going to start with Jupyter Notebook. So for that, you need to just simply click on launch button, and what it will do is it will going to start launching our notebook. See, it has rightly started launching. So it will going to, you know, redirect us to our browser. So since we are doing it for the first time, it, you know, might take some time. And as you can see, it has rightly redirected to our browser. Right, our Jupyter Notebook has rightly opened over here. So here what you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply click on new, and then integer simplicon this Python 3. So what it will do is it will going to open Python 3 Jupyter Notebook. I can see it has rightly opened, so you can set your, you know, title over here. I'm going to set just hello world title, then just, you know, simply click on rename, and you can see our title has been rightly set. So you can, you know, just simply print hello world to test whether your installation has rightly done or not. So just simply write a simple print statement, just simply click on run button, and you can see it has rightly ran, right? Our hello world has rightly shown in our output. So if you see similar result, then all it basically mean is our Jupyter Notebook has rightly installed. So you can use our Anaconda Navigator to launch our Jupyter Notebook. Now I'm going to show you about Spyder. So for that, you need to just simply click on launch button. And again, you can see it has rightly started launching our Spyder. And you can see our Spyder version 5 has started launching. So you can see our Spyder has rightly opened, and it is currently connecting to our kernel. And this is our welcome message. You can just simply cancel it. So this, you know, launching our Spyder might take some time because we are opening it for the first time, so it's totally fine. So by the time our kernel gets connect, we can, you know, write a simple code over here. So I'm going to just simply print again the same hello world. So hello world, and you can see our kernel has rightly connected with our Python 3.9.7. So you can just, you know, simply click on this run button after writing a just simple code, and you can see hello world also rightly shown over here. So all this basically means is our Spyder is also installed. So you can use, you know, our Anaconda Navigator to launch our Spyder as well. And also there are several products like Qt console, which is also a very popular one and is used for, you know, developing GUI application in Python. And we also have RStudio, which is also extensively used in machine learning and, you know, data science related stuff. So you can also use those two products. I have already made a video about RStudio, so you can also watch that video. Link will be in the description. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.